Marhaba, and welcome to the Matrix Green Pill, where real people connect.
Hello, and welcome back to the Matrix Green Pill podcast. It's your favorite host, Shireen, here today. And today's episode is quite the special one. I have two guests here with me, and one of them is a little bit younger than the guests that we are normally used to. Firstly, let me introduce Annemieke Woodbridge, who is the founder of Young Author Academy, which is a platform where children can develop their writing skills and publish their stories. And our second guest is young Giavanna Eelen, who is a Belgian-American 10-year-old author of her very first book, Ellie's Mysterious Garden. Annemieke and Gia, welcome and thank you so much for joining me today.
Hi.
Hello. Thank you. It's great to be here. Thank you, Shireen.
Okay, so let's start off with you, Annemieke, and can you please introduce yourself, give us a brief on your background and how you ended up here in the UAE?
So Annemieke is my name that I love to be known by. Annemieke is my long form name. But yeah, my name's Annemieke and I founded Young Author Academy, as you said. It's a relatively new company. I came to the UAE about 15 years ago when my husband was offered a role here. So we come from Australia. It was a lovely place to live, but of course we could not miss the opportunity to come and see what Dubai had to offer. So yeah, that's how we came to be in the UAE so many years ago.
The Young Author Academy, which I mentioned, how did you get the idea to start something so innovative?
I was actually a stay-at-home mum and studying my master's, 12, 13, 14 years ago. It was lovely to be able to do that. I chose to study as well as start a family. A few years later, after gaining my master's and then deciding to have a family, I have two children. And I spent a lot of time when they were very young, basically home learning when they were very young in the early stages of their nursery time. And I wanted to spend some time with my children, just really finding out what their passions were, finding out the things that they love to do, but also kind of giving them a head start before they started school, just to keep them abreast of general learnings. And I found that my daughter, who is now 12, Bella, she loved story writing, wasn't particularly brilliant at it in terms of getting the ideas that she had. And she had a crazy imagination. So I spent a lot of time talking with her about storytelling. And I noticed that she loved to think of crazy, fun stories, but she would then find it difficult to then put them into words or stories and paragraphs, which is extremely common children. And she was about 7 or 8 at this time. And then I thought, oh, okay, I'd like to improve her skills. So I did that. And then suddenly she would develop the skills of learning how to tell a story in a word form. And then I thought, oh, why don't I publish some of these tiny little stories? I looked into the Amazon publishing model, and then suddenly we had her published in her first book. I think she was 7. And then her friends wanted to publish their stories. So we did that. And then I thought, hang on, I think there is such an opportunity for young children to tell their stories, but to also become published authors. And so that basically is how it began. And so then I thought, why not create a business in Dubai? And you know, the rest is history. That was 3 years ago.
What an incredible story. And I love that it kind of sparked off with something as sweet as just doing it with your daughter and then it growing from there. So what would you say is your main mission with this program?
I think the main mission is, just like I experienced with my own daughter, the main mission is to encourage children who love to write and have the passion to write, but also don't have necessarily the confidence to write, or particularly the children who have stories to tell and have fun imaginations, the children who don't feel that they can necessarily write a story. So that's a big mission that I've very much organically found in throughout developing Young Author Academy. It started thinking that it was great for those who love to write stories and desperately want to publish, but more so now for the children who are not really sure if they can do it necessarily. So it covers all that range of young children who don't necessarily think they're writers. I think that's one of the main missions now.
Right. And actually, on that note, I've also read that writing helps children improve their vocabulary and the essential cognitive skills, as well as focusing on themselves and their personal feelings. Do you agree with this in your experience? How essential do you think it is for young children to write and express themselves?
Oh, incredibly, absolutely remarkably. And if you asked me that question 4 or 5 years ago, I would have possibly just said, yes, of course, it's important. But watching so many young authors now, from the moment of previously having only written, let's say, a few paragraphs in a storytelling session at school, to publishing their own story of sometimes 40 or 50 pages, expressing themselves, all children have such different ways of expressing themselves, right? Some are very visual. They need sometimes the experience of putting something into words. And then, of course, developing their vocabulary. That's extraordinarily important. But then more so learning the process of being able to actually develop a really well-written paragraph. But most of all, I am a massive advocate in keeping the child's writing style their own. Of course, grammar and vocabulary and structure of sentences and all of those writing protocol measures, they need to be definitely adhered to. They need to learn those different things that they learn in school. But when it comes to their style, I really believe that it needs to be enhanced within their own writing style. Each child has their own way of writing something, and that's incredibly important, yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit more about the workshops and the writing courses that you organize?
Yes, of course. At the moment, our typical model of the workshops are a 10-week session program, and the 10 weeks follow quite a methodical process in terms of right from brainstorming through to completing the story. And it follows the structure of each workshop, each session. It follows some fun writing protocols, all discussed, all verbal. At the moment, our workshops are online. Since COVID, we actually adopted an online-only model at the moment. And because of that, of course, Young Author Academy has children from many different countries join. So typically now we have them all as virtual online sessions. And so each workshop, we go through a fun writing protocol where we discuss some fun things. We address every part of the writing protocol, you know, concepts, all of the basic verbs and nouns and adjectives. One of the main things we focus on is what I love to call up-leveling. Young writers love to up-level their own words, but more so they love to up-level me. So I'll actually put in some writing examples and I'll ask them to try and pick apart my sentences, and they love it. They just love doing that. So the workshop model is 10 weeks long, and then I guide them with goals and their own objectives at their own pace, of course. So each week I'll assess how they're going in terms of their story, and we address, of course, all of the very important things that they need to worry about, the story mechanism, the whole story outline, and then, of course, measure their goals and help them achieve their goal by the very end. And then after the workshop, we then go and do all of the proofreading and full editing and publishing afterwards. A large part of it is to help them self-edit, which is really important. And they actually understand where they possibly, they're going wrong. Not that I focus on where they're going wrong, but more so how to enhance their own writing and their own style along the way.
Wow. So it's very in-depth. And I mean, 10 weeks doesn't seem like much to write a whole book, but I guess it's very intense. And like you said, it is still at their own pace, which is lovely. Would you be able to give us a rough idea of how many books the kids part of your program have already published?
Yeah, so literally as of this week, I've published 160 titles in the last 3 years. I think we turned three this week as a company, but there's a lot of compilation books in that as well, and a lot of school books. But in terms of the workshop programs, I'd say 2/3 of that are actually workshop program young authors.
Wow, amazing. And congratulations on turning three. That must be so exciting. I want to hear from you if you have some suggestions to other children who want to try writing but might feel intimidated by the judgment of others, or maybe not confident enough to pursue something like that.
Definitely. You can't even imagine how many young writers, either in private discussions with myself, during conversations we have, actually say at the beginning, this story's terrible, or I don't like how I do this. It doesn't happen a lot, but you can still see that there is the intimidation, because generally speaking, at school, let's say, where most of the young writers get their experience of writing, the writing experience that they've had is either not complete at home, let's say, and that happens to all children. The largest piece of writing they probably have experience with at school is, let's say, up to 3 pages, right? And that's quite a big piece of writing for a school assignment in class. And so they feel like that it's daunting when they think that they have to publish a book. But we start slow in the program. We start with sentences. We progress to paragraphs. I really believe that when it comes to writing, and this ties in with my mission of confidence, which is where it all began with my own daughter, and she went through the same thing, actually. It's really all about gaining confidence through succeeding and through the examples of succeeding. And that goes with everything. When you succeed at something, suddenly you think, oh, I didn't actually think I could do this. And I have that experience with so many of the young writers. They come and say, I can't believe I did this. And of course, they are excited throughout the program. So they suddenly realize, oh my goodness, I'm actually doing this. I never thought I could do this. But I think the paragraph writing and the constant goal setting is actually what helps them feel that they can succeed. That in itself is mind-blowing.
And what tips would you have for the parents that are out there in regards to just reading and writing with their kids or being more involved with all of that?
Even going through this with my 8-year-old son at the moment, so much pressure. I can't speak for all, but I can certainly speak with my own experience and many other parents I speak to. There is this real pressure and competition for younger children to be reading so much. Now, of course, we want them to read. I hear so many children say they hate reading, or I don't like this book, or I don't like having to read this certain book at school for whatever the reading program is. The best advice I can say is when it comes to reading, find a book that your children love. Don't make them finish a book, unless it's a piece of text from school, of course, but go to the bookstore and try a few books that you think that they'll love. Just let them test. And if they don't get through the book, then let them find a book they love. My son has just found, you know, a couple of series that he loves and he can't put the book down. But other weeks when he finds a book that I've wanted him to read, he didn't want to read, he just drags his heels. And I think that's so common. So find a book that you love, even if it's a comic, get them to just fall in love with the actual process of reading. And then it kind of applies the same to writing. A lot of parents, I think the children to get from A to Z academically, from nothing to brilliance in such a short amount of time, it's such a process in terms of reading and writing. Just let them enjoy it. Even if you think that they're not ahead of the game, that's really important. Be true to what their style is and their level.
Right. And would you say that maybe also keeping track of what their interests are for that particular time period? For example, if they have a favorite character or a certain genre of cartoons or animations or movies that they're into, that maybe you can link that to certain books that could be similar?
Absolutely. Yes, like my children have been through the different genres for sure. As a parent, you get to know, you know, a little bit more about what your children are really, really into. And so, and my son's reading the Goosebumps series at the moment. And I think, oh, are they a bit scary? Or because I don't know, I haven't read the Goosebumps series. And he loves them. But it's, you do. You see their eyes light up then when they're retelling. And that gives you a hint, doesn't it? But I definitely think go to something that they enjoy, even if it's a Marvel comic or something like that, and get them just to read and love the art of reading.
Also, it's important to ask, Annemieke, what are some of your future goals that you have for the Academy?
So we have quite a lot coming up in the next year. We have a fabulous illustration program coming up. A lot of the young writers don't like to illustrate. In fact, just detest it almost. And then a lot of writers just love to illustrate. Sometimes the writers will actually be looking for illustrate their books. And then we have a lot of illustrators that have come to us saying, oh, I really want to design someone's front cover or something. And so I've been in touch with quite a number of young illustrators. So we have an illustrators program coming up in January, where I'll be hosting on our website, youngauthoracademy.com, the illustrators portal. And we can match the young illustrators with the young writers. So that'll be fabulous. We're having a writing club that we're going to start. One will be existing authors that we've published, and another club will be new writers. And then another thing we've got, which will be wonderful, is a subscription writing program. And that will be a monthly program. The first month where they will receive a physical pack of goodies, and the following months that they subscribe, they'll receive a monthly digital pack that will include a really fun writing exercise. And then, of course, they can have the opportunity for us here, the team, to critique their writing and also provide them with feedback monthly. So that will be fantastic to provide some progress for them, a progress report, basically. Yeah. So there's lots happening in the next year.
It sure sounds like it. And I mean, that's a lot of exciting stuff for you to look forward to as well. I really love what you're doing. I think it's such a great program, and we definitely need more of such programs everywhere, I think. Do you think you'd be expanding out of Dubai to some other regions or countries?
Yeah, definitely. We've published authors now. In the past 9 months, we've been focusing on outside of Dubai. We have authors now who have published in Singapore, the United States, England, Australia, and India. We have a lot of young authors from India. And then we'll be also having some programs outside of Dubai.
Amazing. Well, Annemieke, thank you so much for sharing all of that with us today. And I guess now to hear it from someone who's got to try the program firsthand, we can speak to Giavanna, where she can share her experience with the program. Hi, Gia. Hi. I'm so glad to have you here. Would you please tell us a little bit more about yourself and why you decided to write Ellie's Mysterious Garden?
Hi, thank you for having me. I'm 10 years old. I grew up here in Dubai with my parents and three older siblings. I love cats. My favorite color is purple, and I love going to the beach. I like going outdoors and playing or riding my bike around the compound. And then I started recently playing drums. I was always a fan of adventure stories and magic stories, and I thought, why not include both? So I drew the characters and the whole book came together.
Wow, okay. So let's learn a little bit more about your book. What inspired you to write it?
First of all, before finding this program, I already enjoyed writing short stories, but that was only for fun. After my parents told me about this program, I wanted to start immediately. I was so excited. Without the help of this program, it would have been hard to create something of this scale. This was awesome. So now I'm writing my next book.
Amazing. Okay. Can you tell us, how did you feel when you were writing?
I feel good and calm when I write, and when I have an idea, I just don't stop writing. In situations when it gets tough, I just take a small break and write again.
And what would you say was your favorite moment when you were writing your book?
I love getting comfy on the couch with a blanket and no one around, just myself and no distractions.
Okay, and how would you say Annemieke and the Young Author Academy supported you during the whole process?
Annemieke helped me with all the grammar that can sometimes be tricky when I'm writing. She would give me some activities to do, like brainstorm, ask to draw my characters to see how they would look like.
Wow, okay. And would you say you have your own personal secret garden?
No, I wish. Hopefully one day I can have one in my dream home.
Okay. And do you have some tips that you would like to share with young writers just like you?
You could add some pictures and you don't stop writing right until you can't write anymore.
Thank you so much for sharing, Gia. It was great to hear about your experience with the program. And now we have come to the segment of our show where I'm going to ask both of you a couple of rapid fire questions. So it's like a little game show.
Oh, I like game shows.
Yeah, okay. So let's start with you, Gia. What would you say is your favorite cartoon and why?
Despicable Me, because there are minions that are really funny and it's a really funny movie how they talk.
Great. Annemieke, who would be that one guest that you would like to invite for dinner cooked by you?
Oh, good question. Elon Musk.
Ooh, okay. Can I ask why?
Yeah, I just find him incredibly fascinating and very, very smart in every field. And I don't know how it's possible to be that way.
Yeah. Gia, what is your favorite country that you've visited and why?
I like Belgium because I love the waffles and french fries.
Okay. And Annemieke, what is one thing that you do every day, no matter how busy you are?
Oh, dear. I don't know if this is a great thing or a bad thing. I write a list every single morning.
Amazing. Okay. Well, thank you both for playing along. It was nice to get to know a little bit more about both of you.
Yeah, that was fun.
And now for our Green Pill Moment segment, Annemieke, I would like to ask you, what Green Pill advice would you give to your younger self?
I think it's very much to do with decision making. I would say to my younger self, not necessarily trust your decision making, but understand how you specifically make decisions, because I think there is a formula for each person, but we have to be honest to ourselves about that. And so learn and know how you make decisions, But trust them. Yeah, trust them, really. And then think big. Think big is, I think, a very big thing I've learned in the last probably 10 years that I really believe it's difficult because executing on that is really tough. But I think if you think big and you don't get scared about what could be, I think that's definitely the advice I would give to my younger self. Don't be scared of thinking big because failing at whatever you think big at is actually not a big deal.
Yeah. And that's something that I guess takes time for everyone to get to that point where they actually understand that.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Right. Well, thank you so much for sharing your amazing story and your experience with the Young Author Academy. I definitely enjoyed this conversation with the both of you. And just before we say goodbye, Mika, if you could share maybe your website one more time and your social media handles of where other people can find you and follow you.
Absolutely. Thank you, Shireen. It's www.youngauthoracademy.com. And my social handle is Young Author Academy on Instagram and Facebook. That's about it. Thank you very much.
Thank you again. And thank you so much, Gia, for sharing your experience. And I can't wait to see what you write up next.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
If you enjoy our conversations, please like and subscribe. See you next Wednesday.